Hey everybody, Unstable Gamer here, and welcome back to Disney Mirrorverse. In this video, we're going to be taking a look at the newest event that has been out for a couple weeks. I wanted to go through the first and second weeks because there's quite a bit of difference between this event and the last event. So my question is did they fix everything? Did they improve on what they had last time? And I'm pleasantly surprised, so we're going to go ahead and dive into that. But first, before we do, if you're just now finding this channel and you want to stay up to date with this and other games, consider hitting that subscribe button so you don't miss out. All right, and welcome back. So just a quick reminder, all the links to my social media are in the description below, so definitely check that out. Join us on Discord, where I'm working on building up that community as well. And another reminder, remember this game is in soft launch right now, so it's not available everywhere. But where it is available on iOS and Android. All right, I figured probably the best way to really work through this is to compare it to the last event by comparing it to my last video that I did for my final thoughts on the Scrooge's Risky Venture event. So let's go ahead, just dive into that. So pros, I only had a couple pros on that last one, which was event currency in store and unlocking guardians. We continue to have that in this one. We had three guardians join, two guardians that you can unlock fairly easy from the store just using the event currency and the event store, which is pretty cool. And then a third one came in, which was Minnie. And Minnie, once you max out a character, you have to continue to collect shards of that character in order to get a currency. That currency will allow you to use it in a special store. The store is where Minnie is, and you need 19,000 of those. I can't even remember what they're called right now, but you need 19,000 of that currency in order to unlock Minnie. So it's going to take some time. So she's really not specific to this event. But we do have the store and the guardians, which was pretty cool. And again, you can unlock them fairly quickly. Now, we'll continue to talk about the pros as we look at the cons for the last one. So still there's no story, which I really feel we need a story for these because we've got some great characters. And again, Disney is known for their stories. So hopefully by the time this game comes around to global launch, we'll have some stories in these events. Also, still only one difficulty level. I think for your higher end players, you need more than one, at least two difficulty levels, because I think for as long as the event goes, so it's open for a week, and then so you got the Ian Lightfoot event that lasts for a week, and then it goes to Genie, then back to Ian, and then back to Genie, so it alternate weeks. So it fixes that gap between event weeks, which I think is great because that gap to me just, it didn't make sense. But they fixed that, which is a very good pro in my opinion. But we do need some additional difficulty levels, especially for the higher end players. So hopefully, again, by the time this game comes around to global launch, we'll see that. Another concern I had about the last event is you couldn't complete all event quests. No, on this one, I think they probably went to from one end of the spectrum to another. So we were able to complete all of the event quests, but there just wasn't a whole lot. It didn't seem like the event quests really provided any challenge, really. It was really easy to complete those. So we go from one event where we can't complete the event quest to one where it just seems more like a formality to just run through the event and complete those quests very quickly. So you can do it all in the matter of an hour or two. And for an event that lasts a week, once you're done with that hour or two, then you're just sitting around until the next event comes around the next week. So that's kind of a pro and a con for me as far as this new event. No replay value. They did put some replay value in there. So when the event comes back around, so when Ian comes back around, when Genie comes back around on those second weeks, then you can run through those nodes again and collect those rewards. So in that essence, where I talk about in this last event where the rewards are lacking, they did get beefed up just a little bit. So I think they did something there. I think probably still, I don't know. Maybe I'll never be satisfied with the amount of rewards that we get. But they did buff up those rewards a little bit. So that was good there. So when it comes to this event currently, again, the no story, the only one difficulty level, the event quest being a little too easy to complete, and then you're left with pretty much nothing to do the rest of the week. Those are pretty much my cons for this event here. Now, next, let's talk about the suggestions that I had, which pretty much we've talked about a lot of them, right? So we need to add a story. We need some additional difficulty levels. Hopefully those things get added at global launch. Also give us a reason to replay the event. I do like that, but how about give us the ability to replay the event during that current week? Maybe not for first time clear rewards like you get when that second week comes around, but at least maybe some reduced rewards so we can run those nodes as much as we want so we can farm during that week, because then it gives people who may be able to clear it fairly quickly something else to do and work towards through that week, and also add some additional event quests that will actually require you to do that so that you can complete all of the event quests. So just, I think for an event that lasts a week, the content should last at least, so let's just say it's a 7-day event. In my opinion, the content should last at least 4 days. 4 days to be able to clear everything, because that gives 2 days for people who may not be able to log in or can't play as much. And those 2 days are pretty much catch-up days. So that's kind of just my thoughts as far as the difficulty levels, the replay goes, and the events, as well as beefing up the rewards, because you do get some additional rewards by doing that as well. So the story, the difficulty levels, give us a reason to replay the event. So I like that that thought as well. I do like that they did fix that a little bit here. And then increase item limit in stores or rotate items. They didn't really do anything there. It's the same store from Ian's store to Genie's store, and then you just continue to purchase items through that store. They don't rotate. You have on specific items, you have a certain item limit. Once you purchase that's it. They don't refresh. So I still think something like increasing those item limits or rotating the store or something, or make the store specific to that event character. So a store specific to Ian, and then the same with Genie. I don't know. Just kind of a few thoughts there. I thought overall, I love the event. I think it was great. I think they fixed a lot of things between the last event and this one, at least in my mind. They improved a lot. I still think there's some room for improvement or some additional things that they can do to kind of beef up these events and that we've already discussed. So overall, I think it was good. I think it's a move in the right direction. So again, I'm looking forward to seeing how are these events going to continue to evolve, right? All right, everybody, that's what I had for you today. Just a quick video to talk about the newest event that's been in the game for a couple weeks. We still have, I think, about a week or so left to finish up this current event cycle, and then we'll see what comes around the corner. All right, everybody, as always, I want to thank you all for taking the time to watch the video. If you liked it, make sure to hit that like button and share your thoughts and questions in the comment section below. Take care, everybody, and we'll talk to you next time.